Okay, the third and final video. Your answers from question 8, hopefully you found that these three were right triangles. Since 6 squared plus 8 squared equals 10 squared, that is a right triangle. 36 plus 64 equals 100. The one with the radical is a right triangle. 1 squared plus 1 squared is equal to the square root of 2 squared. Remember that squaring and square roots are inverse operations. They undo each other. So you would simply have 2 on the right side. 1 squared is 1, so you'd have 1 plus 1. And since 1 plus 1 is 2, that makes a right triangle. 10 squared plus 24 squared equals 26 squared. These three were not right triangles. 4 squared plus 4 squared is not 8 squared. 16 plus 16 does not give you 64. 5, 8, and 10 is not a right triangle since 5 squared plus 8 squared is not 10 squared. 25 plus 64 is not 100. And 1, 3, 3 is not a right triangle. 1 squared plus 3 squared is not equal to 3 squared. 1 plus 9 doesn't equal 9. So, what we want to make sure that we understand is that a right triangle that has lengths 60, 80, and 100 is similar to a right triangle that has side lengths 6, 8, and 10. You can see that these are just multiplied by 10 from these right here. So if a 6, 8, 10 is a right triangle, then a 60, 80, 100 is also going to be. You can just multiply all three sides by the same number, then you're creating one that's similar, and so it would also have to be a right triangle. So on question 9, you're writing Pythagorean triples that are related to the 3, 4, 5 triangle. That means as long as you multiply these three sides by the same number, you're creating another right triangle. So if we multiply them all by 2, we get the 6, 8, 10, which is a right triangle. If we multiply them all by 3, 3 times 3 is 9, 4 times 3 is 12, 5 times 3 is 15, we would get another right triangle. So we're creating more Pythagorean triples, and of course we could do that forever. Just keep multiplying 3, 4, 5 by the same number, and sorry, the lights went out. And you'll get another Pythagorean triple. So if you multiply them all by 4, you would get 12, 16, 20. And so obviously I don't want you to just keep doing that because that would be a boring life. You could go on forever. Now your question 10 in your notes, you actually already solved on number 5. It says use the Pythagorean theorem to find the length of the hypotenuse when you're given the legs 5 and 12. Well, we did that already back on question 5. We were given legs 5 and 12, and remember we solved and we got the hypotenuse to be 13. So question 10 is just like the first part of question 5. That's another Pythagorean triple, the 5, 12, 13. Since all of those are whole numbers, that's what makes it a Pythagorean triple. So in question 11, you want to use this triple to help you solve for the missing part of this triangle. And so remember, the longest side is the hypotenuse. So since the 39 is a multiple of 13, it's just 13 times 3, then you can see if this leg is one of these that's also been multiplied by 3. And it is. It's 12 times 3. And so we know that this side would have to be the 5 times 3. This is just the triple 5, 12, 13, and everything's been multiplied by 3. So 5 times 3, 12 times 3, 13 times 3. So A would have to be 15 in this case. Now you have to make sure the two sides that you're given are indeed two of these sides that have been multiplied by the same exact number. So what I mean is this one can't be 13 times 3 and this one be 12 times 4. That's not going to help you find that side right there. They have to have been multiplied by the same number. So since both of these were times 3, then you would just multiply this by 3 to get the missing side. So like I said, that can be a time saver on a lot of timed tests like the ACT, if you'll recognize those Pythagorean triples. So knowing your triples will allow you to solve for some of your unknowns very quickly. So hopefully if you see a 6 and an 8 for legs, you'll recognize that as the 3, 4, 5 triangle, that have all been multiplied by 2. 3 times 2, 4 times 2. So what would x have to be? 5 times 2, which is 10. Here we have 12 and 20. The 20 is the hypotenuse. You might not recognize that as quickly, but that is also the 3, 4, 5 triangle. This is 5 times 4. Okay, this one is 3 times 4. So this would have to be 4 times 4. The 3, 4, 5 all being multiplied by 4. And so the x would have to be 16 in this case. Obviously, that was not drawn to scale because it looks like it's smaller than the side with the 12. But that's all the 3, 4, 5 that's been multiplied by 4. All right, your assignment 14.1 will be due on Wednesday since we will be AIMS Web testing tomorrow. Good luck.